Salutations, Proboscis 2 here. Here with a tutorial that's a little more of a miscellaneous thing. It's not necessarily a something that you can only do with a SpongeBob game, but I'll be testing it on a SpongeBob game today. So, yeah. Today's tutorial is how to patch Action Replay codes, certain ones anyways, to an executable, so you can build them right into the game. Now, this only works with certain codes, and first of all, they have to be codes that start with where they have to be codes where all the instructions start with 04. Because 04 is, I think it's some kind of RAM write. It's there's more to the name than that, but it's basically a RAM write. So basically, we can patch these values into the executable using a hex editor. Now, there are two codes that I know work. Actually, there's three that I know work, but two that I'm going to be showing today. Those ones are the 60 frames per second driving, bubble bowling, baby hunt, and I think that's googly eyes and smelly knickknacks. So, I know this works because I've tested it, and I know the movable paddy wagon camera works, but I'm not going to be showing that in this video. And what was the third one? It was, cruise boost. The normal cruise boost also works. The instant cruise boost is an example where it's all RAM writes, but the problem is the other thing that'll prevent you from patching certain codes like this one is that you won't be able to find the value the address in the DOL where you have to write the values, because the 04 says what type of instruction it is. The other part of this the columns on the lines in the columns on the left, this part is the address in RAM where it patches the value here. So, say, here's how we find the address in RAM. You have to have Dolphin on debug mode, and you can see that's why it has all this stuff here. And you open up, well, first of all, you have to have the Action Replay codes. Wait, that's Gecko. Okay, so here I have... I just realized I never tested any of these. You know what? It's fine, because we can just go to the addresses. So, open a SpongeBob movie game. Actually, I could just use the vanilla one. Can I? No. I don't know. I didn't have an ISO set up for this video, so I'll do that real quick. Let me stop this for a second. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow, in a one-horse open sleigh. Alright, so I have this ISO I extracted and rebuilded already. This is the one where you're going to be basically dumping the RAM from. So I just set it so that it automatically boots into Bubble Bubble Baby Hunt, and it doesn't show the menus. And I also gave all the characters, or SpongeBob and Patrick, their upgraded moves and health. So that's pretty much all I've done to this ISO. So let's go load the one I built, AR test. Make this make this bigger. That should be good. I'm not gonna put it in full screen mode for this tutorial. Because I want you to be able to see that I don't have any action replay codes enabled. Turn my volume down. So, yeah, looks normal. Frame rate is terrible. And what we are gonna do now is, let me pause this. What we're gonna wanna do now is go to, let's see if I can remember this. I think it's like, no, it's memory dump MRAM. There we go. Now, Avast. Okay. Now, dump it again. I think he can do it while it's paused, but in case not, I'm OCD. So, now we open our documents. Let's see here. Close this. Documents. Dolphin emulator. And dump. And here we have mem1. This is the RAM dump. So you'll see the game's ID up at the top. And now we can search for, or go to, the addresses listed in the action replay code. So, for example, the 60 frames per second code. We'll copy the address and paste it. Go. And here we go. This is 38000002, which we can see is very similar to the code's value, 38000001. So I guess this is the mode in which the game loads the frames per second. So you can see here, you can actually see some of the IDs for levels. Like, here's Shell City, here's, what is it, Tough Tug, and here is Planktopolis. I don't know if that's a coincidence or not, but it doesn't matter, because we're gonna take this line, and, basically what we need to do is search for this area in the executable, so you can see these, like I just mentioned. So we're gonna copy this, line of hex. Now we're gonna open the executable. So let me see. System data, start.dull, search, find, hex values, paste, go. And there we go. It's exactly the same. Now, this is the part where a code like the Instant Cruise Boost wouldn't work, because here in mem1, there's no area that at the address for that one address in the AR code that I mentioned that looks similar enough to, you know, the area in the memory dump. So it completely ruins any hope of finding the correct offset in the dull to paste that value in. So, well, I'm not even going to paste it for this. All I need to do is change this to 1. Oh, 1. There, we just patched the 60 FPS code. And now we're going to patch the, Cruise Boost code. So, let's see. Let me pull this back up. Ooh, my back hurts still. I'm gonna search for this address in the memory dump. Find. No, wait, that's the wrong one. Search go to. Paste that. And here we are. This is the normal value. we need to paste this value, but first we need to find this area in the DOL. So we'll copy that row. Search, find, paste. And let me see if that looks similar, because sometimes they repeat. Similar enough. You can see the area with the 3/8. Yeah. It's hard to get it lined up correctly with the scrolling, but that's definitely the same. So I'm going to copy this value and paste it into the DOL. I believe this is the right part. Isn't it? Let's see. So if this matches... Oh wait. Yes, it does match it. Okay. I'm stupid. So, yeah. Copy this. Paste it into that area in the DOL. There. That's one of the instructions. We have to do the other four. So, it's the same process. I'm just going to speed this part up when I edit this. Okay, so this part isn't entirely the same, so I have to press F3 to search again. Let's see, it's gotta be the one where it's all in the same row. Let's see about this one. No, that's not it. This one? Oh, wow. Yeah, that is it. Oh, it's the area where I patched earlier. So... Okay, I need to take this and patch it to, what was the area? 110? Here. All right. Okay, these are on the same screen, so I don't even need to search for this. It's the same as the other one, right here. I should really maybe patch the other one, just to keep my memory. Okay, last one. I don't think I'll speed it up for this one. Just in case I have anything to say. Search. To. Paste. Okay. Copy the row. Search. Find. Paste. Okay. Is this the same? Oh. Precise match. So, let's see. Where was I supposed to paste it now? In ED4. So, here. Right there. Copy the value. And paste it in the DOL. Alright. Save. And you can cut the backup. Make a new folder in your ISO or root. Name it. I'm gonna name it DOL. Damn. Well, I'll just leave it like that. And paste it in here. You gotta make sure there's nothing else other than these four files in the and system data folder. Otherwise, GameCube Rebuilder will not rebuild it. And just to have a backup of the original DOL, go to Options, Modify System Files, and Do Not Use Game.Tuck before opening our root. That way, it'll build the backup DOL into the ISO build that we're making, just so you can have a backup. Let's see, where is it? There, tutorial, root. See, there it is. Start. Oh. It's a good way to. It's a good way to keep. What the heck? Oh. I forgot to close this. It's a good way to back up your files by keeping them in ISO builds. Just in case you have to delete them somehow. But, anyways. Yeah, let's open the game back up. And I'm going to emphasize the fact that I have no AR codes activated. See? I don't even have the codes that I would need in order to make this effect on here. You have to get the key to the padding. And there we go. It's in 60 frames per second. Looks really smooth. Now, I just realized, because I'm an idiot, that Patrick is the player in this level, which means I won't be able to show you the cruise boost. So, I'm going to stop the video, and, well, I might as well show you gameplay first to show it's really in 60 FPS. Hopefully it looks as smooth in the video as it does right now for me. What? Yeah, okay. I'm gonna stop the video, and I'll come back with SpongeBob, so I can show you the cruise boost.
Cut your dick off with a knife!
Alright, it's loading right now. Let's see what happens. Let me turn down this, my volume. Okay, so I have a confession to make. I'm not good at the cruise boost at all, but I can show you that it does make the noise. Oh, I have to turn on my volume for this so I know it. Yeah, it's working. So let me see if I can get him moving. You have to be moving for it, I think. You know it works because, look, I just activated it a little bit. It's not fast, but I can try to do it faster. I think the method is like you have to do one way and then another one the other consecutively. Try and show it off again. There, I'm moving a little bit. Yeah. And again, let me pull this up. No codes enabled. So, yeah. Let me close this out. So, yeah, that is how to patch action replay codes, certain ones anyways, to a GameCube executable. Or an ISO. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.
'Cruise boosting! Fuck yeah! Slow? Fuck that! 'Cruise boost that bitch! Oh yeah! We're going fast, baby!
SpongeBob to Mission Control, this shit is sick!
Jump you can't make?
Fuck that!
The world is your oyster with
'Cruise boosting!
Just ask this guy!
Yeah, I had sex with some girls after I told them I knew how to cruise boost. It was pretty cool.
If you want to have sex and fuck anyone, you...
Whoa, slow down there, Eager McBeaver.